what was the practice of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu says, anna imra'atan yahudiyatan atat Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam bishati masmumah. A Jewish woman came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and she brought poisoned food to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, poisoned meat to him. And فَأَكَلَ مِنْهَا, he ate from that. He was gifted, so he ate from that. And Imam Ahmad says, فَقَالَ إِنَّهَا جَعَلَتْ فِيهِ سُمَّنْ. He said, when he ate from that, it was revealed to him that this food, this mutton, this meat was poisoned. So he informed the Sahaba, the companions, that this food was poisoned. What I just ate was poisoned. فَجِئَ بِهَا إِلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. The companions went and brought that woman to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَسَأَلَهَا عَنْ ذَلِكَ. He asked her, why did you do this? Why did you poison me? فَقَالَتْ أَرَدْتُ لِأَقْتُلَكَ. She said, my intention was that I wanted to kill you. I wanted to kill you through this act. I wanted to poison you and I wanted you to die. قال ما كان الله ليسلطك على ذلك. He said, Allah would never have given you power above over me. It is not possible for you to kill me when Allah is there to save me. فقالوا, people said, ألا نقتلها. Should we not kill this woman? She attempted the crime of killing, trying to kill the head of the Muslim nation. This is an attempt of assassination. If somebody tries to assassinate the president of a country, what will happen? Will people leave him or her? No. This woman gave poison to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and she admitted, she confessed, yes, I did it and my intention was to kill you. So it is a crime and she has confessed the crime. A very clear confession is done. People ask, should we not kill this woman? She did a very heinous crime. Should we not kill her? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, la, no, you should not kill her. And Anas radiallahu anhu says, فَمَا زِلْتُ أَعْرِفُهَا فِي لَهَوَاتِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. I always saw the effect of this poison in the throat of Rasulullah صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. He was hurt and he always suffered from the poison and I knew this. But Prophet صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ did not take revenge from this woman and he did not order the Sahaba to kill this woman. So if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam were a person who was rude, who was a terrorist, who was a person in a, you know, successful way of killing people, he had everything. No one would have prevented him from killing that woman. But he left that woman and he did not kill her for that sin of poisoning the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this hadith is narrated by Imam Al-Bukhari and Muslim.